Quick, what's the first Bible verse you think of when I say Great Commission? It's probably Matthew 28, 18 through 20, right? You know, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, to the end of the age. Matthew 28 is the flagship of the Great Commission, and it's an important part of our Christianity today. But it may be even more important than you realize. There is a driving force behind the Great Commission that is often ignored, and it makes our witness far more pivotal. What is this driving force? What is the heart of the Great Commission? It may surprise you to find out that the heart of the Great Commission is actually a vision about Jesus from Daniel chapter 7. The prophet Daniel, who at the time was exiled in Babylon, received a rather alarming vision of the future. He saw a snapshot of the rest of human history, featured by four different animals, each representing one nation that would rule over the entire world. But as unstoppable as each nation became, they were all soon overthrown by one like a son of man. To him was given dominion and glory and a kingdom, that all peoples, nations, and languages should serve him. This is the climactic moment of human history, when Jesus is inaugurated as the undisputed king of the cosmos. So what does this future coronation have to do with the Great Commission? Well, Matthew shows us in chapter 28. All authority was given to Jesus, just like all authority was given to the Son of Man. All nations are impacted by the Great Commission, just like all nations are impacted by the reign of the Son of Man. And Jesus anticipates the hope of the end of the age, just like Daniel anticipates the hope of the end of the age. This, and much, much more, tells us one thing. Matthew 28, 18 through 20 is reenacting Daniel's vision of Jesus, the Son of Man. This means the heart of the Great Commission is the exhaustive victory of God's Son. Every time we participate in it, from evangelism and baptism to discipleship and teaching, we are rehearsing the future triumph of our King with the transforming power of His gospel. The future reign of Christ, then, compels us to do our part in the Great Commission. We long to see Christ King, and so we embody this hope until He reigns.